Welcome. In this demo, we're going to see how to create a dashboard from an audit log using Tinybird. With Tinybird, we ingest data from different sources, transform it using SQL, and publish endpoints with very low latency. For this example, we're generating simulated events for an audit log with this schema. We have a script that constantly sends events to Tinybird. Ingest, transform, publish. The data flow is users with their activity generate events. These events are sent to Tinybird using the events endpoint for high frequency ingestion. Once data is in Tinybird, you transform the events data using SQL in pipes to create results with the best possible schema for each use case. Finally, in just one click, you publish endpoints that optionally use parameters. In this way, you have APIs from which you can create data products with Tinybird for any use case. Dashboard consuming Tinybird endpoints. This example dashboard is a web page with three widgets. Upper left, a count of the number of log entries. Below that, a table with some information on each entry, and a chart that groups by event type and time for the selected time period. We can use the company filter to change the table and the chart. And the event filter to change the table. The chart is updated in real time. Each time we change a filter, we send a call to Tinybird with the selected parameters. We can also use the date selector to get the events for the days we want. How it is done with Tinybird. What we are doing is sending all the events to the data source audit log HFI. As you can see, they are stored in a tabular format, and we already have 41 million rows. Using this data source, we can create a pipe to work with the data, where we can write SQL in each node and run queries on our data source. Here, asking for the count, the oldest event, and the newest event, we see that the dashboard updates in real time and the whole table is read in only a very few milliseconds. We can rename our node to give it a meaningful name and comment with markdown on what we are doing. A good thing about working in notebooks is that from the next node you can run queries on the previous node. If you no longer need what you did in a node, you can delete it. We're going to write a query for what we want to show. We select the company ID, author, event, and date time. We rename our node and pipe and comment the pipe with the fields that we're going to select. We go here, up on the right, to create API endpoint, select the node, and confetti. And in one click, we have our endpoint. Here we have our response in JSON with each one of the selected fields. We can also have it in CSV format. With this, we can start to create data products with our APIs. If we want to parameterize it, we use our templating language. Here's a quick guide on how to use it and what you can do with it. Define parameters, pagination, errors, conditionals. Let's add company ID as a parameter. Add a where, and inside curly brackets, we put the parameter name, company ID. We can set the default value and write a description. We can see how by changing the default value, the response changes. On opening the endpoint page, locate the parameter and see that changing its value changes the response. To see how we create the endpoint for the chart, let's have a look at its pipe. In the first node, we apply the filters and select the time and the event for each row of the log. In the next node, we query the previous node and count the number of events for each event type and each hour. To generate a column for each event type, what we have to do is generate an array of the event types and the count. And finally, generate a column for each event type. In the endpoint page, as we've seen, we have the parameters and the code snippet to get the response in JSON or CSV. From here, we can open the documentation page that can be shared with our front-end team. Here you have your orientation page, so you're creating a secure environment and giving access to the endpoints that you wish. Of course, you don't need to know how to use Tinybird to be able to consume its endpoints. This page shows all the parameters, and here you have the code snippets that tell you how to consume the endpoint and the preview of the response where you can see the effect of changing the parameters. With this set of endpoints, it's very easy to create data products with Tinybird. In our dashboard example, each time you change a filter or every few seconds, we are calling the Tinybird APIs. Since they have such low latency, the charts are updated in real time. That's the end of the demo. We hope you enjoyed it. If you have a data product that you would like to create with Tinybird, don't hesitate to contact us.